Welcome to TPP, the Peasent's podcast. We are the community DayZ console podcast featuring owners, coders, streamers and players from the game we all love. We discuss everything from updates to ideas to help the community and devs understand what it's like to play console DayZ. The podcast team comes from all corners of DayZ. Streamer and content creator on both Twitch and TikTok. Smiley's got a gun, likes to delve into the personalities of the players and find out more of what it makes them tick. Long-term player ADKcue adapts to the server's style he chooses to play and is out to beat any challenge DayZ can throw at him. From survival servers to roleplay, Q's out to try anything. Our quietest member of the team, Mr. Noah, explores the world of DayZ on old gen and gives us the feedback of what it's like with a knack of glitching his character in all sorts of forms. So you'll see him in the background doing some weird and wonderful things. And the lady in chat, Queen Peasent, the Horde's favourite person. The controller of chat and the voice of the people. She is quick to fact check and keep the people informed. Lastly, the man who controls it all. Myself, the greedy peasant. Long-term Xbox player, addicted to DayZ, content creator on all platforms, with a passion for keeping the console DayZ dream alive. Welcome, everybody, to the Peasants Podcast. Ooh, something you found on eBay today. It gives me a little hint. Probably somebody selling kits or someone who's selling or duping kits. Big shout out, Mr. Teabag. Welcome, welcome. We've been with the Horde for 27 months. Big shout out. 2 years and 3 months strong. 100%, bro. Preach to you. Mr. Teabag is from CDS, a massive coding firm that has been associated with the Peasants for a long time. Very good friend of mine. So, ladies and gentlemen, what's on today's show? As I said, we're going to have a couple of guests on. We're going to talk to Dan the Man and Valkyrie Kane. We're going to talk about the update. We're going to delve into a one-on-one and find out more about the personalities in the DayZ community. Of course, we've got Zombie Bowling, which is in front of me. This is where we launch our guests in cars at these priests and get them to knock them down. We're going to be running through with the co-host takeover. So we've got Q's Corner and Smiley Cesspool. And of course, then we'll be sitting there and talking about a little bit about the game and the update of 1.23. So, let's get this show on the road.
Mark that to
Hey, look, for once Bruce, it's not Bruce, Smiley hey, bringing out bus. The vulgarness. Hallelujah.
Good morning, everybody. I think that's someone that's going to be matching Smiley's
energy. Yeah, I think I've got to just sit back. The filth and degeneracy
knows
today.
No bounds.
Yeah. 100%.
Ah. Oh, my sneer gets a chicken. How are you?
Oh, it might be our man. It is, Mr. Valkyrie Kane. Hello, hello.
Yes. Hello.
We've got the timing of the champions. So, hey guys, how's it going? Having a lovely weekend, or at least a start off?
Oh, yeah, hungover as usual, boss. Hungover? Really hungover.
Yeah, we did some gaming till, I think I went to bed at 4 a.m. It's now 9 a.m.
Oh, yeah. Jesus. Feel so very like a swallowed a cat.
Yep. Typical console cold game.
Which is fucked this morning.
Hangovers. All right, so on today's show,
little hangy.
Got a couple of absolutely wicked guests. The man, our luggage man at the moment, carrying the sea chest, is Dan the Man. Welcome, Dan the Man. Could also merge into the second guest, which is Corporal Poop. So we might have either come onto the show today. These particular gentlemen are celebrity stars in a lot of servers that we played in and still playing. So you get to have a chat with him. We're going to get one-on-one and find out a little bit about what goes on. Of course, in our officer gear, we've got Smiley's got a gun. And on the opposite side, in our thug gear, we've got ADKcue. Welcome, guys.
Morning.
Howdy.
And on our right, we have Mr. Valkyrie Kane, our server owner. How are you, dude?
Hello.
Somewhere buzzing around is, of course, Mr. Noah floating around. We will eventually get him to talk live on stream. But we'll see how we go. Rightio. So, second week into the new update. Everything seems to be going all right. No real big issues. How's... oh, actually, before we get into it, little news from the co-host. What's been going on, bruv?
Oh, that's a trick question, isn't it? I don't know. What aspect of my life would you like me to discuss right now?
I believe you opened something
new. The
clean ones.
The clean ones. Oh, the DayZ related ones. Yes.
Yeah, from
I have,
the DayZ show.
The Deathmatch server. Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's where I am. I opened up a Deathmatch server, bruv. Been good the other day. Reached, when we all got on, we nearly capped it at full. And yesterday, when I was working, unfortunately, I had a look, and I had 12 people on there that I didn't even know. So I was like, ooh, people are, you know, finding out about it, jumping on, having a run. So that was good. That was awesome. And yeah, really happy with it. Pretty pumped.
Yes.
It's called Death Metal PvP. It was, built it in a fever over 4 days, and digging it. It's got a good vibe to it, so yeah.
Happy
with my new baby.
Definitely get out there and have an explore. It's called Death Metal PvP. You'll catch Bruv on there every day, sitting and having a fire and a chill, still trying to get off the coast. It is located all the way out west. You do spawn there, but she's just still hanging around the coast.
Yeah, I must say, though, I do like a little King of the Hill action at PD.
Yep.
Still, PD is still my soft spot. You know, I've got a little PD up back, and So I'll usually be hanging up that up around there, or driving the cars.
Or driving the cars.
There too.
And what's been happening with you, Mr. Q? Working hard?
Not a lot this week. Haven't actually had much time to game this week. It's been slogging out the work.
Good old RL gives that little little kick in the ass, doesn't it?
Yep. It's alright, it's Sunday, it's game day, hell yeah.
100%. During the week, we disappeared and went camping with the missus, so we're only freshly back to cranking up the computer and getting back into it, so it's good to have everyone back on stream. Let's dive into our little one-on-ones. I'm going to go into Mr. Valkyrie Kane to start off with. Ooh, you'll be a liked man.
Ooh, me first.
Yeah, you get first. You get first priv.
Oh, lovely.
That's it. So we're going to sit down and grill you now. This is what happens on the Peasant Podcast. We just fucking...
Yeah, zoom right in on there, boss. Zoom right in.
You get the grill, happening. Little
Smiley already does that in my DMs anyway.
Yeah, true, facts. Bruv, you're doing your
that
homework.
Was
I'm proud of you.
That's funny how we met.
I'm proud of you.
It's funny. There's a female Valkyrie, and I thought I was sending her a message. I'm like, hey, how you doing? And you got the wrong one. That's how me and Val became best friends ever since. We talk about builds and stuff, and
it's amazing.
A happy accident, wasn't it, Val?
That's it. It's amazing what happens when someone slides
into
your DM. Especially when you don't know.
I never get DMs anymore.
That's it. After this, the DMs may change. So just a warning on you, sir. Just a warning on you.
Oh,
I don't know that.
All right, Valkyrie. Give us a little detail on your servers, because I know you own a few, and what are they about? Give us a little rundown.
Well, all my servers begin, it's a tier system I'm doing.
Yep.
Like a beginner, intermediate, then advanced. So, starts off, I believe, I can't remember off the top of my head what order I've made them. So you've got Blood Moon as the beginner. Then it's, what's the other one called? I can't remember. I can't remember what the other one's put. I called the other one.
You're gonna have to double check that. So Blood Moon, Soul of Janaris, and Silver
yep,
Town
that's it.
Dirt.
Yep. Souls of Janaris is the intermediate one that's more a KOS involved. And then Silvertown is the hardcore, everything spawns badly damaged, you need to repair it all. No mags spawning guns, you need to find it. You need to repair guns to even use them. So that one's quite hard.
That's a,
I don't get by the coast on that. I don't even get by the coast on my own server.
That's a very good way to progress your servers, especially having a brand like you do, allowing your players to progressively get harder and harder and harder.
Yep. The Blood Moon one's the most recent one. I've not finished all the coding I'm doing on that.
Yep.
Taking a while.
It is easier to do the harder ones, I find. There's less coding. Everything just goes to zero and little numbers.
Yep, that's it. That's exactly what that is.
Yeah, that's it. And then as they progressively get harder, you've got to, you got to put in those extra builds. You've got to adjust the numbers so everything sits right. But yeah, 100%.
Yep.
And population's going not too bad, or they're just kicking off? They're just warming up?
The hardcore one isn't going too bad. The beginner one is always low pop. There's not many people that go for beginner servers.
Yep.
But then when you get the one player that's on there constantly, trying to learn. I've went on that a few times and there's the same guy that's been on there learning how to build a wall for the last 2 hours.
Yeah, nice. It's a good spot for people to go and have peace and quiet without having to go and purchase the whole server. The concept is starting to grow more and more.
Yeah,
I know of a few other servers that are out there teaching people, and even the owners going out there and taking the people by the hand and actually teaching them the game itself. So it's absolutely wicked to see.
Well, that's how I actually met my admin. Yeah. I met him on another server, and I just taught him the ropes of the game, and eventually he's beating me in gunfights now.
And it's funny how you hand over the reins of the teaching, and somebody else excels more than you and can survive further than you have.
Yeah, same. It's quite sad.
It just means that you spend more time in the valuable bits, in the editors and the servers and stuff like that.
Yeah, I've not actually set foot in one of my servers for about a month now. Been too busy coding.
So, what got you into server ownership?
It's a bit of a sad story. I started off, it was a server, what was it? Called Born, it was Born to Kill or something, and I'd been on that server for months and months, and eventually the owner decided to give it up.
Oh, yep.
And I was hoping, at that time, I wasn't in the position to own a server, but I was hoping someone would take it off him and, take over. But unfortunately, that one went down, and I went to official, and that's hell.
Yep.
That's even harder than my hardcore one for me.
Yep.
And then obviously I just decided, screw it, let's take a leap of faith and open up servers.
And that was the last time you played the game?
It feels like it.
Yeah. Yeah, it's definitely... yeah, it's a big step going from player to owner.
Yep, definitely is.
And then what made you go from 1 to 3?
It was the... people were saying that some stuff was harder, and I've just decided I would open... I started with 1, thinking, right, I'll see how this goes. That one picked up quite fast.
Yep.
That was the one... it was called The Torment.
Yep.
It was a 32 slot, and that 90% of the time it was full. Like, if I went to go on it myself, I don't put myself onto a priority queue or anything.
Yep.
So that everyone can get in and have fun. But I was sitting sometimes in like a 10-man queue waiting to get into my own server.
It's a disappointing and proud moment when you're sitting in a 10-man queue in your own server, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely is. But yeah, so I just decided I'll open up another one. Instead of upping the slots and risking people leaving because it's too crowded,
yep,
I would just open up more.
Yeah, nice.
If that makes sense.
Yeah, it does. Yes, it gets to a point that servers can get unstable, you know, around that 50, 70 slot mark. So a lot of people do like yourself and open up a second, you know, another 20 slot or a 32 slot just to keep that server being able to handle it. We were on a official last night, and it was 54 out of 60. And by the end of it, it was unplayable. You know, an hour and a half after restart, it was just people were jittery everywhere. We had a red server icon. Connections were fine. It's just we had a red server icon. So,
well, that's one thing I will say. I had that at the beginning, but that was because of my server location. I had set it to be located in the UK. And after a while, I realised if I moved it to the Frankfurt server, US players could play and I could play without any issues with connection.
Oh, that's all right. So on the EU side, you use the Frankfurt servers because it's closer to the US guys rather, and it's better for the US guys as well.
Yeah, rather than having it in the UK. I'm in the UK, but I still had a red server icon and connection issues.
Shit.
So it seems to be the ones closer to the Nitrodo, like, main office are the ones that are maintained more, shall we say.
And I've also heard that London servers do get a bit iffy when it comes to the population, once the population gets a bit higher.
Yeah, so as soon as it hits over 20, it starts to really lag.
Yeah, especially on the London servers. Frankfurt's I don't have much problem on, but like I do the same thing. I host all mine in LA's because the US has the biggest population of DayZ players. So, you know, you got to put your market in the right spot to be able to attract the right bees. So, definitely smart things to do.
That must be how I don't see many fellow Britons in there.
Yeah.
Nearly everyone I've met has been American.
Been American. It's because it's the US player population is pretty much 2/3 of the DayZ population. So that's just how the odds roll in.
Is.
They got the bigger population for it and bigger drive for it.
Yeah, it definitely is.
So, apart from, you know, the DayZ world and stuff like that, what do you do on the outside of DayZ?
Well, on the outside of DayZ, I'm into my karate.
Yep.
I do karate and I teach it as well.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. First Dan black belt.
Yeah, nice.
Oh.
That's
a black belt and everything. Holy fuck, yeah, right.
That's
Got ourselves a Jackie Chan here, Dan.
That's it.
Yeah, don't mess with me, I'll beat you up.
can I ask what style?
It's a Wadaroo, it's called.
Oh, nice. Nice, nice. No, I'm a...
there's a lot of styles.
I'm a coach in Krav Maga myself, so I'm a bit of a fan of fighting.
and I used to do boxing for a while as well, but never got really into that.
Yeah, nice. But yeah, back to you know, the ownership and stuff like that. Do you have any you know, good, you know, the best and the worst moments of owning a server?
Oh, the worst moment was update day. Yeah. That was it. That's the worst moment. My first update day, and oh my god, I broke the server like 7 times. I gave up and trying to add the new bits in and just wiped the server.
And just wiped it and just got it done with. That's the easy method.
Wipe it.
That's the easy method.
I tried the hard one.
Just wipe it and let it do its thing, get all the new stuff in, and I'll start again.
Yep, that's what I've done. I backed up all my, like, the way I had the files, but instead of the numbers being the same, I slightly lowered them a little bit to make it a little bit more challenging.
Yep.
So every wipe, it'll be a bit more harder and harder.
Progressively make it harder and harder until it gets to that crunch point. I mean, for people that play hardcore servers and challenge themselves on hardcore servers, once you go and play, you know, boosted or official, it just you can see the difference in your game and how easy it is. So if you
look, when I started on official.
Yep.
That's my first ever server I played on was EU like 2000. That was the first one I played on. I'd done really well, built a base and everything, then died and couldn't find my way back.
I think we've
didn't
all
know
been.
I survived was a thing then.
I think that's what we've all headed down that little path where we've lost, you know, stashes that we've built that we could never go back to, especially in the early days.
Yep.
Where do you see the game heading in next year, in 2024? What would you like to see in it?
Well, I've heard rumours of DayZ 2 coming out.
Ooh, we're going to actually talk about that later in the show. A little touching base on DayZ 2 and what the progression and whispers has been on there, so...
But one thing I'm hoping they do is allow Derail and The Mask, all the PC maps, to be able to be used on Xbox and PlayStation.
That's it.
I think that would bring a flair of people into the game.
Yes, definitely a new map would be, or a change in the map would definitely be what could be required. I definitely agree with that. What are your future plans for your servers? What have you got in the works?
Well, I've got a revamp of Northwest Airfield.
Yep.
Since I've made it all flattened out, I've decided to bite the bullet on that as well and decide to rework it all and make it somewhere that someone would actually want to look.
Yep.
Because even on normal official servers, it's not the best place to look.
No, I think the intermission crates need to be a bit more, maybe even spread out around the place. The cargo plates, the cargo drops seem to not produce exactly what they're supposed to, which is heli loot. So, I have found official has drawn a lot more into the inland PvP sides of it. But yeah, the old Northwestern Airfield got a big shaving down and is a little bare, but I'm glad it's flat. That allows the community to do their thing.
Did you see the hype about the opposed bunker?
No.
Have you been in the new bunker in Northwest?
Yeah, I know what the new bunker is like. It's not really a bunker, it's just a bomb shelter.
It's a basement. That's what I thought. It's a basement to a building. It's not even anywhere remotely close to a bunker.
Nah.
And that's what I'm adding in. I'm making an underground bunker, or at least trying to.
Oh, nice. Gonna make the rabbit hole, eh? What we all thought was gonna happen, which was the tunnel underneath Northwestern Airfield.
I am going to make it. I'll make it in the air and then lower it down into it.
Yeah, that's how I do it.
Yep.
So when it comes to, you know, having three servers and stuff, do you have an admin team or do you run it all solo?
I've got an admin to handle the Discord side, but in-game stuff I tend to handle myself. Like, for if it's needing an immediate server restart, the admin have, like, the commands on the bots to restart the server from the Discord.
Yeah, nice.
So it's like most of the coding, building and all that is done by me.
Yep.
And then they handle the tickets for traders and all that.
Yeah, very nice. You got a little team running all three. I suppose you'd need it with all that work.
Oh, it's hard work.
100%.
Yeah, it's hard work.
And speaking of how much time do you, on average, do you spend, you know, managing the servers, coding on a weekly basis?
Oh, well, when I first started, I quite literally went 5 straight days with no sleep coding.
Shit.
Now, I do sleep now, not as much as probably is healthy, so it's maybe, I'd finish work about 5 o'clock in the afternoon,
yep.
Get home at 5:30, have my dinner, then go straight onto the PC and start coding. Now, the only day I don't do any coding is a Sunday, a Tuesday and a Thursday. That's the only days I take off for coding.
Jeez. So 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, putting big hours into coding and the workplace.
Yep.
What was it?
Do 11 hour shifts in work. And yep. Then come home and do more coding.
Do more coding.
Sometimes when work's been slow, I've even logged into my Nitro and the works computer and done coding and work.
Yep. That's how you know it's not just a passion, it's a love.
Yep.
Yep, 100%. 100%. But that when is hectic.
When somebody hears that, they're quite shocked at how much time I've put into it.
Yeah, that's it. And a lot of people think, you know, how can you put that much time in it? But it becomes a love and a passion and, you know, they become your little kids.
Yep. Basically, I don't have kids in real life, but these basically are my kids.
Yeah.
The servers.
That's it, baby. Sing them a lullaby before you go to bed. Before you restart them.
You know something? I've probably done it before when I've had a drink in me. I'm not gonna lie.
Oh, that's gorgeous. That's gorgeous. Well, that's the end of our one-on-one with Valkyrie Kane. We've got a lot to do in the rest of the show. I appreciate you getting a little one-on-one with Greedy.
Yes.
Now we're going to...
So I'm getting distracted by the guy with the sea chest.
Yeah, he does that. That's it's his turn now. He tries to run away, but we'll have to get his official name. We'll need Corporal Dan to stand attention down here, please. That's it. All right, Sergeant.
Hey, it's Fred. It's Dan the Man, President, Chena Roos, and I love you, always. Proud of you too. You're a champion, a force of nature, a PvP combat expert, and I wouldn't have it any other way. I'm so very proud of you. Look at me right in my eyes and know that you're the true champion.
Dan the Man, welcome. How are you, bro?
I'm doing pretty great most days. How are you feeling?
We're feeling pretty good, pretty relaxed. So, Mr. Dan the Man, we met a long time ago in the world of DayZ. Blurting his good vibes over the PAs.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
And he's got a couple of characters buried in there, so we're going to meet a few of them today. But first of all...
You may very well.
We would like to... what's the inspiration for your voices and your characters?
Well, I'm going to let you know... The reason why I'm the president of Chain Our Roots and I do what I do is... In the PvP, PvE arena, it's a thankless job. Sometimes you get sad. You want to break free. You made it through a week. You made it through a day of the IRL. Now it's time to cast that aside and become a PvP champion. You'd come into the virtual world and relax a little bit. And there's somebody there to tell you, you're doing a good job. There's somebody there to tell you, I'm proud of you. And they mean it. That's me. That's why I do it. I want people to know that I care about them. You know, there was a person named Robin Williams. And what he said, a quote that stuck with me my entire life was, you know, I spent a lot of time feeling useless. I felt like I was useless. So I chose the job that I do so I could teach other people that they're not useless and they never have to feel that way. And that stuck with me. So that's why I do what I do. That's why I'm the president.
Oh, that's a...
That's beautiful, Dan.
It is.
I like that.
Big shout out to Mr. Robin Williams. A big inspiration in my life.
Yeah.
you know, the man did his good work all the way from back at Morecambe Indy all the way up to entertaining us right to the very end. So, yeah, definitely a good quote to roll out with.
A true champion,
100%. So, how long has Dan the Man been alive? How long's the character been around?
Inception date, December 22nd, 2019.
Ooh, very nice. So right into that COVID period.
That's right.
And both Dan the Man and Corporal Poot get right involved in the content creation?
Oh, yeah. You know, Corporal Poop and I are not friends whatsoever. We're a completely separate entity. We're not pals, but he does involve himself.
Yeah, yeah. Yes, he's not as polite and elegant as Dan the Man is.
Oh, he's a bit crude and brash.
Very, very crude and brash. That's it. With Dan the Man and Corporal Pooh, what happens, what do they do for a living on the outside world and the real world?
I'll tell you something. If you didn't notice by now, or you didn't notice before, I work in the entertainment industry. Entertaining the citizens of Chain Our Roots. That's my job. Full time.
And absolutely doing, good job about it, but when was the time that you picked up the PA mic and decided entertaining the people of Chinaris was what Dan and Corporal Pooh had to do?
Let's get it on. I'll tell you the tale.
Let's do it.
2019, January, Prison Island, 16-day siege against dupers of all types. Hackers and bad boys living on that prison. And we had to get in there and take it over. They couldn't hoard all the gear from those freshies and take their time with them. So we went out there and we made them stare at us. And we gave them some love and some care and some attention of the PvP style and taught them about brotherhood, honor, and respect.
That's absolutely hectic.
That's how it started.
Fucking yes.
That's absolutely hectic. Good old epic story. And from there it began with the lovely call from Dan the Man over the top.
Dan the Man showed up, took over. You know, there wasn't a leader in Chain Our Roots. All right. There was no one leading anyone from that broken boat and riffy westbound, northbound. And didn't show them how to do it. Nobody was showing anybody how to do it. They were hiding in Cammy, in the PD. They were getting greasy in there. So I had to show up and guide him and lead him into victory at all costs.
And that you did. That you did. So what server do you currently play on? Where can we find Dan the Man or Corporal Pooh leading the people?
Oh, get ready. PvP, all cats, PvP 4, PvP 5, the Daily Dot, not to mention Prison Riot, and I love Come Town. Also, plus plus P is all right sometimes, but I recommend PvP at all costs. PvP 4, PvP 5, Prison Riot, Come Town. These are all very good servers that'll help you be top notch.
Some of the favourites that I play are definitely on there. I'm a big fan of Come Town myself.
Yeah, I want to hit PvP 5. I heard some good stuff about that. I still haven't jumped on there yet. I'm seeing a lot of talks and a lot of... Yeah, I'm going to get on there.
It's beautiful, and Zelenogorsk gets beautiful. You show up, and it's just a beautiful ride.
Yeah, I'm going to get on there.
Go to Zelenogorsk and go roll with some inspirational words from Dan. So what's your thoughts on the update and the new gear?
They're gonna buff it and nerf it, but this right here, the DMR. This is the sweet boy, the whole new thing. It's real good and goes as fast as your finger will let it and goes really far and long and is an extremely accurate weapon. I do recommend this weapon if you want it.
That's it.
Damn, I love it. I like all the new updates. I like the four-wheel drive functions of the vehicles. I like the traction of the vehicles. I like the way the character's beards start growing. Did you know that you could grow a beard in your character? Did you know you could grow a big old bushy beard and your hair grows when you're bald? Well, I do, because I grow them all the time.
Yep. I love getting a fat beard. I think the beard is the notable side of a character. If you've got a big fat beard going, you know, especially on an official, that shows that you've been alive for a while. It's a symbol.
Take a look at the sky, Greedy. That's the president. Look it up there and look at the sky. Beautiful, beautiful things of the whole update. So pretty and beautiful. It takes a menagerie. Look at that circle I just made for you. Look at that perfect circle. That's I made it for you just like that, you know, because I care about you.
Yep, and just ignore the little puff that's way up there in the sky. That's Greedy's.
That's just the fart.
Don't worry about that. That's a cigar.
That's the
DayZ
gods looking down on us.
It's fine. Those are the ones that get mad at you every time you take a break to go to the bathroom, get a snack, and you get red screen.
Yep.
Hey, you know what? That reminds me. Those of you out there that are listening, chat, I want you to press F4 in the chat for your bad feelings. And I want you to have some good feelings and remember, here in the Bohemia Interactive world, you're not dying. You're just being recycled. It gives you a chance to come back stronger, smarter, more well-prepared to face the enemy. And you will face the enemy, guaranteed. But fear not. You'll be able to respawn, re-gear, and get back out in the field where you belong.
100%. That's absolutely great advice. Absolutely great advice.
You rule the adrenaline.
We want to know where we can maybe find, you know, some upcoming stuff that Dan the Man's doing, or some upcoming stuff that Colonel Poop's doing. What's next for them, and what's the future plans for them?
Well, the next plan for Dan the Man is to continue to lead into glory, and with DayZ 2. Maybe, poking around the corner, there might be a whole new world to take over and be a champion there as well. And I'm just so excited to do it.
Yeah, 100%.
Oh, if I do make any type of content or update it, it will be on Reddit. It will be on the Greedy Discord. And there'll be links, you know, I'll post them. It'll say my name in big letters. I've seen it.
Yep, 100%. So there you go. You can catch him on Reddit. You can catch him on... the Greedy Peasant Discord. If not, let me know, because I post a lot of it.
Internet-wide.
Internet-wide, that's it.
Anywhere.
Internet-wide, 100%.
I heard there's videos of me on the internet that I didn't make, that other people had authored and posted on the internet, which I greatly appreciate that.
That's it. 100%. for those people who are out there posting some of the content, you know, 100% love them. 100% love them. Alrighty. Well,
let me just yell it.
Yell away.
Wait, let me turn my TV down. I want to do a shout out to my buddies on the radio.
Please DC do.
Radio. I want to give a shout out to Fair Gorilla, Lieutenant Ihorn, and also Detective Finkel. Those boys are strong and good, and not to mention Goblin, Greedy Peasant, Smiley, he's got a gun, the boy, and also Dr. Dangler. I just wanted to thank those people from the bottom of my heart, and you at home watching this. I'm very proud of you. You've come a long way from that broken boat and riffy. I can't wait to see what you do next.
Oh, much love, Dan.
That's it.
Oh, preach, man.
Inspirational words. And we appreciate definitely you getting involved. Words. And that's the end of our little one-on-one. So before we throw you into the pit of snakes, we're going to test your skills on our little zombie bowling course. Yes, that was absolutely very inspirational. So you want to follow
me? Don Vellante's burning down the house for the insurance money tonight.
Oh, yeah.
I'm upset that I had never come across Dan the Man before today. He's fucking awesome.
I met Dan all the way back in the aggro servers. Oh, that's it. Pull up. That's it. Now you can run over as many as you can. That's Dan.
Be alive.
He's alive.
Yeah, that's Dan. He's having a little sleep.
He's having a little sleep once he gets out of his unconscious form.
Yeah.
Could wake him up.
Wakey, wakey, Dan.
Let's see if it's still working, Dan. You can drive that car around and mow him all over.
Yep. Start her up. There you go.
That's it. So start her up and drive and kill him. You can stay in there. If a car still works, you can run him over.
Yeah, run him all over. Run as many as you can over. That's it. Just
keep
don't
going
fall
to
off the
car.
Edge.
That's it. Keep going till your car's busted.
Alright, yeah.
Valkyrie can go whenever he likes. No need for waiting. Here we go, car's coming down. Whoa.
The fabulous doughies.
That's it.
Yeah, nice form. Very nice form, Dan.
Well, I think Noah just lost his track.
Poor Noah.
Ooh.
Close to the edge then, Dan. You got it.
I don't know, it's pretty good precision control there.
It is.
There we go, second on the board. Oh.
He's gonna get all of them here.
If you could push that, if you could use the new mechanic and push it off. He's still a tad answer. Good strat, but good strat, the reverse doughies.
Oh no!
He killed himself.
He ran himself over with his own car. I didn't even know that was possible.
Noah's stuck in the wall. Could someone just go for a walk and just kill him? He's just left-hand side of the jump. How many ads you get now, Epic? Valkyrie, you can still keep going if you can push it. Yeah, if you can push that off. That's it. Oh, yes. Now get in. It should stop.
Yeah,
get in and run them all
woo-hoo
over. Nice. That's the new mechanic at work. So run as many as you can over. You do have three cars. Watch out for somebody else coming over the jump. So how many is there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Still standing on this side. So out of possible 20, so that's 13.
And for 100 years
of I think you're pushing yourself out of that.
Oh, he's wedged in.
Yep. So currently Dan the man is on 13. Valkyrie might take out the whole bottom section here.
Oh, he's doing pretty good.
There's 16 at that bottom section.
Got a lot of smoke coming from that car there.
Yep. Looks like he's got a few on the edge, but right over there, he's pushed a few onto the edge.
Yeah, so they get a bit difficult to clear up when it's right on the edge.
Yeah, it's usually a suicide mission to take one with you.
Oh. Hey, Dan, you can get other cars too.
Oh, smart, Dan.
He's going to see
that. He's going to hop in.
Let's push it off. And Dan, you got two more cars. Leave your gear there and grab your two more cars.
One more, boss.
One more?
He's had two.
Oh, he's had two?
He's had two.
Yeah, done. So currently it's 14 to 13. Noah doesn't have a score. Valkyrie's in the lead.
Poor Noah, he keeps getting himself well wedged in those walls, I tell you.
He does, doesn't he?
It really does, hey. If there's a server that, like, that you could possibly get put into a wall, that's him.
That's
every
him.
Time.
He'll do it.
Yep. You don't know how, but he does.
So Dan's got one more car and Valkyrie's got two. Noah's yet to jump.
Yeah.
Oh, here we go. Oh.
Oh, oh nice.
Here we go. This one's coming in like a bat out of hell. Oh.
Look at that, just slowly.
Just slowly.
You clipped it. You failed. Try again.
That's it. Try again. I think we do open up after the podcast for everyone to jump in and have a crack. So the server resets every 12 hours, so you're more welcome to jump in any time and have a crack at it. Do a CC comp on it one day.
Who have we got left? Val's got one left, is that right?
Yeah, I believe so.
Noah still has his three.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh. Tina Tyler.
Always everyone's undoing, huh?
That's it. It's the middle. The middle. You got to get enough speed to clear without flying yourself over.
You want to fast travel? Do you want us to fast travel you? All right, watch that. I can assist.
That's it. We do fast travel
maybe.
Well here.
I don't know if I can get it with this range, but let's try.
So our test is.
Nah, I'm not going to reach. Where's Q? Reach Q.
Ha ha. I think that was jumpy today. The car went in, and then now there's a lot of smoke. So I think that might be it.
That's it?
I think so. I don't think no one can get his...
Everyone's had their threes?
Yep. I believe Dan's had his three. He got 13. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, so he got 13 and Valkyrie got 14. There's only two standing up on the other side, isn't there? I can't see a third one.
I'll have a look.
So there should be 7 on this side, on our side, and then 2 on the other. And there's 20 on this side and 16 on the furthest. 1, 2.
Yeah, we've only got 2 on the side, boss.
Yep, that's it.
Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4. There's six on this side.
6?
6 on this side.
Doing a 1, 2, 3.
Pretty handstand.
Oh, shit. That means we have a draw. I don't know what to do with the
draw. So there's a piece of poo here on the ground as well. I'm just saying. Hey, Q, come and have a look at this piece of poo. Look.
Oh.
It really is a piece of poo on the ground here, Bob.
Blood on it.
Smells good, don't it?
It tastes good.
Corporal poo! And the poo.
I think it is the corporal poo.
Oh. Hey, Noah.
Look.
The fuck?
A piece of poop, bro.
Hey, look, what's that doing, man? Yeah,
he's still good. All right.
You're doing all right there, Noah.
There's both our guests won with a score of 14 each.
All right, okay, I gotcha. Yeah. Oh, he's delivered the weed.
Bought the goods, yes. Bought the goods.
Nice.
It stinks, don't it? You can smell it, can't you?
Uh-oh.
Yep. It's Corporal Poop! And
the
Poop Crew, too! You know what time it is, don't you? Time for you to ask me some questions before it gets too good to get, huh? Hope you brought enough lip gloss to smoke. It's Corporal Poop, baby! I'm sick of your nightmares. And you can tell by the scary music what time it is. I hope you're not attached in your virtual junk, because it's going to be good, ain't it? It's going to be getting gooder than you thought it was, huh? When it's Corporal Poop and the Poop Crew, huh? You never know. My poop's gonna strike next!
Oh, God. So I told you he'd be here soon.
Yes. There he is.
Hello, Mr. Poop.
Welcome, Corporal.
That's right, so...
It feels good to get, don't it?
That's what a few car accidents does. It shakes the...
Delicious.
It shakes the characters around. But for Zombie Bowling, first ever in nearly 30 episodes of it, both guests tied. Our leaders got 14. Our guests both got 14. And hectic effort. Big GG to you. But now it's time to do what we usually do about halfway in the show. Yeah.
Masturbate.
That's what I go and do while you guys do your takeover.
I'm stealing.
Touch each other. It. Tell None each other that. How
you
pretty
first.
We are.
You out front.
How pretty, pretty.
All right.
You're pretty, Val.
Mr. Q's corner.
It's question time.
Oh, God.
How are we, sir?
Come on.
I quite like your gilly. It gives me a very good shot of your gooch. I'm enjoying that. I'm enjoying that. I'm sure you might be enjoying me watching it, too.
Smell good to get when it's too good.
Oh, yeah. Eat it. So, Mr. Poop, where is your favourite area in DayZ to go smear that good old violence?
It's Northwest Airfield, baby! And Cammy, too! And I like to make problems in the prison!
Oh, the prison? Yeah, I've got a feeling that's where you should belong, sir.
I'm known, of course, for being bad all the time.
You're a bad man. You're a bad, bad man. Well, I'm gonna walk away from Mr. Corporal Poop now. He's making me nervous.
Don't worry about it.
Must say, though, he smells
it's
delicious.
It's fine, babe. It smells good. And it's getting good, too. Ain't it? It's Corporal Poop and the Poop Crew. Train in the ancient of Poop Foo. And getting you. If you hear this, you know what time it is, huh?
Yes, sir. Oh, you're gonna enjoy Smiley, I tell ya. Mr. Valkyrie, please save me. Please save me.
I'll save you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. So, when you're running around on your server, what's your favourite spot? Where do you love to go hang out?
Underneath the bridge at one of the bases I've seen.
Big part of where?
Under a
there's a bridge. And I like to go under the bridge and torment the owner of the base by talking and gaming.
Oh, nice.
Likes to be a true troll.
That's a true troll. Trapping under that bridge.
I'm the Scottish troll.
The Scottish troll.
Oh, I love it.
Give me weed and I'll let you by.
Oh, well, thank you for your time, sir. I'm going to keep it short and sweet this week and hand it over to Miss Smiley, because I'm sure you're going to have a ball today, lady.
Oh, wow.
Oh, don't remind me of my
phone. Oh, no. Oh, this is going to be a good time. I'm so glad that Corporal Poop could turn up today because... boss, we are still doing the 10 grossest sex acts as described in Urban Dictionary, and the two that I've chosen today, I think Corporal Poop are gonna like. He's gonna love this. He's gonna enjoy this a lot. He's gonna froth all over it. Okay. When they're finished having their little bonding moment.
That's it. Guns away till the end. It's the end of the show that you get to murder each other.
Yeah. Last question, you can bring out your guns.
That's it.
All right. So this question is for... This is a question I'm going to ask for both of you at the same time, okay?
Ooh.
Okay, because there's two parts. There's two parts to this question. Okay, are you guys ready? So... There is, in the Urban Dictionary, there is a, I know this is probably an American term, so I'm going to try and, pronounce it. The Kentucky Klondike Bar. Who's ever heard of the Kentucky Klondike Bar? Okay, so basically what it is it's the act of freezing a bowel movement That's a poo. So active freezing a bowel movement and sexually penetrating another with the frozen bowel movement. We're going to use it in a sentence. I wanted to give my partner a Kentucky Klondike bar, but my shit took too long to freeze, so we watched the newest episode of Two and a Half Men instead.
Okay.
Yeah. I don't know how to make up these sentences. That's just what the example was of how to use that one in a sentence. So you've either got that act or the second act that you can choose. The second act you can choose is the Panamanian petting zoo. So the Panamanian petting zoo, when one forces one partner to pick the nuts and corn out of a bowel movement.
Yeah, I know this one.
The partner then presents the nuts and corn in a cup or a dish. They present it to their partner. And then they toss the nuts and the corn onto the bed where the partner eats them like a goat or any other typical petting zoo animal. Are you ready for me to use this one in a sentence?
This is not the first time I've had this discussion about the petting zoo.
Oh, God.
If you want to use it in a sentence, I had the biggest shock of my life when Jason asked if I'd like to go to the Panamanian petting zoo with him. Everything was fine until I saw the corn. I don't remember eating corn. When the hell did I eat corn? So there are two acts today. So you know how we have to bring it into DayZ and make it all about DayZ.
Yep. This is the fun
whenever
part.
I'm at the Zolinotaurus petting zoo, yeah. I always make sure to get while it's getting good. I'm eating some of it right now.
Would you like some corn? Actually, that's our question. Because I just thought of that just randomly just now. What other vegetable would you like to see in DayZ?
Eggplant.
An eggplant?
Yeah.
Well, you were pretty quick to answer there, Val. Like, that was actually really fucking fast, man. You've been thinking about an eggplant for a long time, what you'd like to do with an eggplant?
Yeah.
Yeah, right. Oh, yeah.
Nice. Really getting involved there.
Yes.
Make it like Josie's mod. Like Josie's mod on PC.
All right, like a little dong mod.
Oh,
what an eggplant dog.
Yeah.
Oh. An eggplant dog.
My fireworks are blowing out of control.
There are different ones. Dead man, look.
What I want?
There are different ones. Look, it says thank you.
You know I like all fruits and vegetables. They make you healthy and feel good. Cool. When it's feeling good.
Is there any corporal poop that you would particularly like to have added in? Something that you would like to treasure and carry around with you in your personal... personal space?
It'd have to be cherries. Never seen any cherries. Never seen any strawberries. Never seen any puffy little strawberries dangling around.
You like some berries? You want some berry action?
Mm-hmm. Gonna have to be getting some berries in there.
Nice. That's our questions for today. So we have berries and eggplants. So we'll get right on that. We will contact the devs and ask if we can have berries and eggplants. For
that's it. Some berry bushes
reasons.
And some, that's it. Some eggplants.
So there is, do I have time for the last question, boss?
Yep, fire away.
The love story moment.
Yep.
Oh, God.
Might even be able to crack Melba's love story.
Oh, boss, you're going a little quiet.
Ooh.
I mean, we can hear you, but you're just a little quiet.
Just a little quiet. Volume. Hello, hello.
Oh, that's better.
Oh, that's weird.
Much better.
I have to devour my mic.
All right, so the next question that we have for Corporal and Val is your love moment. Tell me about a love moment that you've had in DayZ. A moment where you've thought back and thought, God damn, that was like an epic moment, or something that like really tickled your heartstrings, and something that you reflect on every now and then. It might just, you know, pop into your mind and think, this is why I play the game. This right here, this moment here is why I play the game. But tell me about a love moment. How about we start with you, Val? You got a love moment?
It's quite like, literally a love moment.
Oh, you fell in love?
Yeah, my girlfriend plays DayZ, and I met her in one of the games. One of the servers I play on.
Oh, wicked.
Aww. We have a love story, bruv. We have a love story. Oh, so how long have you been together? Yes, love.
6 months.
6 months? Nice. Which server did you meet on?
It was the original one that I played on.
Oh, nice. So you just randomly met?
Well, I didn't realise at the time, but she was in, like, my faction. And it turns out she went to the same school as me.
No way! So you were actually in the same country, and you actually knew each other?
Well, partly knew each other. We hadn't really spoken before, and then we actually started talking properly after we met on DayZ.
And then you worked out that you actually went to school together?
Yeah. Because she heard me talking to my pals about, like, a girl I met on DayZ, and then she realised it was her that I was talking about.
Really? No way!
Yeah.
Holy shit, man. So, okay, so you're 6 months in, going strong, so you can actually see each other in real life, right?
Yep.
Ah, so do you have, like, little dates where you sit down and play DayZ together in real life? Like, side by side and stuff, or?
Well, that's what we were doing until, like, half an hour before this started.
Really? So she's there with you at the moment?
Yeah. I think she's keeping the dogs quiet.
Holy cow, man. Bravo. I must say, I don't know. I
That's
think
love
that,
moment.
That one takes the cake.
That's
I mean,
a love moment, definitely.
What are the chances? Oh,
that's crazy,
absolutely.
Mate. That's crazy that you went to school with her and discovered her in your faction. Like, it's not like even on your server.
And everything.
It was in your faction.
Oh, that's incredible. Oh, thanks, man. Thanks for sharing that. And well, how about you, Corporal Poop? Tell me about a love moment that you've had.
Have you
lost, Corporal?
Oh, me? What kind of situation was I getting in? It was real greasy and full of love. Well, I can tell you. One time, I showed up uninvited at a podcast with Greedy Peasant and Val and Smiley. And I hung out and I fell in love with the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man who accidentally dyed himself blue from hiding inside the urinal from me. But we fell in love, and I poked his eye out. And we fell in love, and I poked his eye out. And we fell in love, and I poked his eye out. Ain't that right, baby? It doesn't say burlog for no reason, don't it? It's Corporal Poop, and you know what it's gonna do. Some of you have met Corporal Poop and the Poop crew, and to that I say, feels good, don't it? And to the Poop crew, it's getting real good.
I love him. I got up and I just love him. That's amazing. I love that. Was a beautiful love story as well.
It's true.
Let's not rule that one out.
It's a real story. It's true love about real stuff. Help, 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 help.
I love it. Noah, looks like you've got yourself a new friend. He's gonna poke your eyes out after you fall in love. And then you're gonna fall in love and poke your eyes out again.
So you can see what I'm doing to you.
Oh, that reminds me of I did a course once. It's called In the Mind of a Serial Killer. This is IRL, by the way. And it was talking about the guy was a forensic, forensic something. And he was a profiler. And anyway, so he was talking about all these different crimes and shit that he'd seen. And much like Corporal Poop story here, there was this one dude who, it was in the middle of the day as well. She was just I don't know if I should be saying this or not. This is one of those times where I think, there's a line in front of me. I don't know if I should walk across it or not. Right?
Well, I think if you're looking at the line...
Maybe. I'll tell you what, I'll save that one for next week.
Yeah,
yeah, we'll test the waters next week. I'm having a good time this week. I don't want to be kicked in.
You've got a good love story, Kraken, so you want to push the limits.
I'll extend my stay an extra week. Oh, bro, if you're talking, we can't hear you, by the way.
Why can't you hear me?
The sound of silence.
Yeah, that's, you know, Liz, he's so dumbfounded by Mr. Poop that he's taking his voice away.
Maybe Corporal Poop put
all
something
right, can you
in
hear me
his
now?
Mouth, and now we can't talk.
Hello, hello? Hello, hello?
Is there something deep in your throat, bruv? Is there something wedged in there? Oh, here we go.
Hello.
Oh, there we go. That was weird.
Beetlejuice, baby.
That's right, Beetlejuice.
All right. We also got our questions from chat. So if you've got some questions you want to fire away, you're more than welcome to. But we're going to roll into our larger discussion area where anyone can just queue in and have your bit. First of all, we're going to touch base on the starting loadout. So starting loadouts are great, but the ability not to be able to select your skin. I think that's... Wrong way.
Yeah.
That was last week. Right, try that again. Rehash. And cue.
And action.
DayZ 2 has been whispered about being made. What's your thoughts about DayZ 2 and what do you think will happen to the original DayZ? So to give people background, there was documentation found with Bohemia about registering DayZ 2 and bringing that... situation alive, so I don't have much information. I had a look online. There's nothing online that you can find about any information on it. It's basically just a trademark. So what's your thoughts on a second DayZ coming out without even the first one fully complete? Noah?
Yeah, maybe they're like, just like, this one's too broken. Let's just make a new one.
I mean, that trademark when they did that was quite a few years ago, though, wasn't it? My recollection of it being brought up before. Like, it's not a new thing.
No, it's not a new thing. It's just more and more prominent now. We're missing a guest.
Are we missing a guest?
I agree with Smiley here.
Yeah, Val's here. Oh, we're missing.
Maybe Dan's coming
Dan?
Back. Dan's probably coming
Dan?
Back.
Oh God, I hope so. Yeah. Corporal Poop scares the shit out of me.
I think he's delicious. I like Corporal Poop.
Oh, I think he's wrong. I like him. He just scares the shit out of me.
Makes you want to have a shower after you speak with him, huh?
100%.
Yeah.
Oh,
now you know what my girlfriend does to me every night. She terrifies me.
That's officially unrecorded. You can buy a deletion for 50 subs to Greedy Peasant.
Yeah.
But yeah, so there's been whispers of DayZ too, but I honestly think it's just a trademark thing for future proofing for themselves.
I think so too. Yeah. I mean, that we're going to end up seeing the normal DayZ go next gen only, and then they'll look at bringing out DayZ 2, I'd say.
Yep. And, I mean, that brings me to my second question. You know, with the full loop happening currently at the moment, the re-loop,
don't worry about it, pal.
With Armory Forge Journo map, are we all going to go back to armor?
I don't think it has the same pull, to be honest.
No.
It's good, but...
It looks good.
Maybe when we switch to next gen, people will, you know? Because I think that's the blocker at the moment, is because you have to be next gen to be able to play it.
Yep.
Yeah. I saw, you know, Dope Magic, you made a talk on... The DayZ in armor.
Yep.
On the Chinaris
map building armor.
Yeah. I don't know. It seemed a bit like he was. It was actually, didn't have the same sort of, I don't know, depth or. So like he just, it didn't have the. I don't know. I think I got the impression that he found it was like a little bit meh. You know. But I'd be interested to go over and have a look and have a poke on it. Have you had a go on it yet, Q? I haven't.
Nah, not yet. I haven't played armor since released. I think I played it once and I was like, I'm going back to DayZ.
Yeah, that's one that we were.
I liked it.
We were still figuring it out and trying to work out how to get games going. I mean, we had a few sessions where we were just playing backwards and forward shooting, but that were only in little scenarios. Mm. I don't know about full map.
Yeah, the little PvP. Yeah, I never got into the full map, but I really liked the little death matches, little PvP arenas that they had. They were a good time.
Has Dan the Man or Corporal Poop played the Armory Forger?
Oh, yeah, I've played some Armory Forger in my life, and one of the things about that game is real pretty, real nice, and everything's fun, but it's too many times to have to download too many things at once, in my own personal opinion.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, downloading the mods and stuff like that.
Yeah, facts.
Yeah, fair enough. That's definitely a good point to it. That's one of the reasons that a lot of people stay in console is so you don't have to go and download all those mods and, you got to flick onto a server, but you need to download 100,000 things. So, yeah, definitely a good point.
Oh, yeah, it's annoying as fuck. Yeah.
Currently, I think it was earlier this week, DayZ hit records of players coming back and playing the new update. And they've also been awarded they've been nominated for a Steam Award.
Yeah, saw that. Yeah.
Get out there and vote, everybody at home who's watching and who can do what you can do. Get out there. It deserves an award.
That's it.
I know a buddy of mine who got banned from the Reddit for typing about how this game deserves a reward. So, it does. If it's touching that many hearts and that many souls and that many feelings, then it should get something. It should get some sort of accolade. It's a lot of hard work.
A little recognition.
Absolutely. It's thankless in the PvP, PvE arena.
That's it.
You boys deserve it.
100%. Wouldn't agree. I definitely agree with you. And then all it takes is a little vote. You can go out to Steam and give them a vote and give them a thumbs up. Got a few questions.
It's more than a game, isn't it?
People are out there voting for their favorite OnlyFans people, and they're voting for their favorite etceteras and so forth. And doing all this, you can go on to Steam, you can click the button, you can vote for DayZ, and you can tell them, Dan the Man, President Jane Arus sent you.
In the comments.
Swear at him.
That's it, swear at him. Fuck, we'll give him the award.
Swear at him.
That would be awesome. See that, like, if you put all comments
and
it all
the terms
just
of service
says,
and get him.
Dan the Man sent me. From Dan the Man. That would be epic. Actually, legit peeps, if you are going to vote, put that in.
Get in there and vote.
It'd be awesome.
Make the game the best you can.
Couple of questions from chat. Dan the Man, what made you get into voice acting and putting on voices and stuff?
I just like seeing people smile. It's one of my favorite things in the entire planet. Just seeing big, bright smiles. Knowing that people are happy. You feel all right.
That's cool.
You make me feel all right, Dan. 100%. Make me feel good. Appreciate ya.
Hey, yo.
If DayZ bought in onesies, what animal would you like yours to be?
My animal would be a bear, of course.
To be a bear onesie? What about you, bruv? Q?
I like the traditional, we've got to go the bunny.
The bunny?
I'm going to go the bunny.
No, it's going to be the earthworm.
A bunny.
A dino. Be a nice fat T-Rex.
A fat, the inflatable style ones?
Yeah, that's right. I'd run around and be like, I got no arms.
And you fall on the ground and it's like, can't get back up type of one.
Yeah, freshy run where there's 13 velociraptors running down the fucking coastal roads.
Yeah. I've done that. There's a sailor that has that.
Yeah. What about you, Val? What ones are you dressing up in?
Closing the antlers I've got on.
The little antlers.
You want to be a reindeer?
I want to be a reindeer.
Want to be Rudolph?
Want to be Rudolph?
You want to be Rudolph? Oh yeah, you probably would get one this time of year, a Rudolph one.
I have one.
Ah!
So we had a few of the Christmas items up here. They've been heavily poached, but a few of the Christmas items. Which one's your favourite? And what do you want to see for next year?
A full onesie in game.
Yeah, I'll take a Christmas onesie. A Christmas onesie. You know, like the bad sweaters. Christmas onesie. Yeah. Yeah. with the little buttons on the butt. You know, with the little flap.
Oh yeah, like
the little assless flap onesies. Christmas time.
That's it. The Long John style.
Yeah.
Stepdad written on the front.
Long John.
That's
it. Right. All I want is for them to add the matching jerseys to the gloves.
Yeah, so you can put the gloves. Beanie.
What are you talking about? The sweater.
Yeah, the sweater. Yeah.
The sweater, you mean.
Like that.
I don't understand. I just don't understand why they didn't bring that out as well.
It's a lost opportunity,
that is.
They still call them Cosby sweaters, or are we not allowed to say that anymore?
No.
Oh, okay. I'll just ask. I'll just put it out.
I don't get the rule. That's what he always wore.
Yeah, no, but you know, bro.
No. I'm trying to cover it, bro. I'm trying to cover it.
Oh, right. Yeah. All right. Yeah.
Yeah, because that's what he wore.
The problem. Sorry.
That's what he wore.
Oh yeah, because that's what he wore. Anyway, what next question? What was the next one?
Queen Peasant wants to see an elf suit. Noah wants full Santa clothes, the whole suit.
An elf suit would be cute.
And that's the... one more question to go. Our last question that we usually put on.
My last question is,
show me what you do to freshies when you meet them.
I protect them. And I love you always. That's what I do to freshies.
That's it.
Protect them. It's Dan the Man, President Chainar Roos. I'm so very proud of you. Greedy, you survived it.
I survived. I appreciate you not killing me and letting me do my outro.
I needed you to do your outro, and I needed to protect you from the freshies.
That's it. The freshies will be coming. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that was an absolutely wicked, wicked podcast. I'd like to thank our guests, Valkyrie Kane from Agony, and of course, Dan the Man and Corporal Poop for coming out. We're glad they both could come out. Absolute legends. You'll be able to find them in the PvP, PvP 4, PvP 5, Come Town and Prison Riot, and Valkyrie Rolls with the Agony servers. So you're more than welcome to catch them anytime you want. You can get a hold of them in my Discords. If you'd like to invite any of these guys to your service, of course. Big shout out to our... Oh, there's Dan. A big shout out to our co-hosts and our podcast team. Absolutely legends. We'd like to get as many personalities as we do on the podcast here. So if you'd like to be a guest, contact me via the DMs and we'll be able to get you rolling on the actual guest list, get you on the show. We're nearly up to our 1 year. We are up to episode 44. So we're cruising to our 1 year, but a big shout out to our guests. And of course, all you guys in chat who come out weekly and sit with the show. It is 2 hours of our time. And progress should come across. We love your work. Snap. Appreciate you. Ladies and gentlemen, that's the time we have. We'll catch you next week. If you want to get onto the server,